गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट द न्यू सब्जेक्ट दैट इज प्रैक्टिकल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स फॉर बीटेक फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर टेक्सटाइल केमिस्ट्री टेक्सटाइल टेक्नोलॉजी स्टूडेंट्स. एंड इट हैज टू लेक्चर्स पर वीक एंड विल रेफर बेसिकली टू टू बुक्स दैट इज प्रैक्टिकल स्टैटिस्टिक्स फॉर टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री पार्ट वन एंड पार्ट टू बाई जी ए वी लीफ. It is a book published from Textile Institute Manchester and a very good book. So first we'll go through the syllabus. Statistics is a very wide subject. In this subject we will try to introduce you with the different topics and try to understand their practical application. So theory part will be some basic understanding, and we'll try to cover the numerical part, and at different points I'll share different numericals, and you can refer these two books also and other numericals also I'll share with you, and we'll do it on Google Classroom. So as we can see, this is your syllabus, and after introduction we go through first second part is we need to understand the meaning of these terms, that is population, sample, random and assignable variation. We'll discuss all these things. Then under third unit we'll study some standard probability distributions, geometric, binomial, Poisson and normal. Then we'll try to understand this central limit theorem. The two main topics are estimation, that is chapter 7, and hypothesis. Under hypothesis testing, we'll study three techniques. One is t-test, one is analysis of variance, and one is chi-square test, goodness of fit, and independence of attributes. After that, this rank correlation and coefficient of concordance is a very simple topic. And after that, we'll study quality control charts, which are basically quality control tools we use. That is also a very easy topic. And correlation and regression, linear regression, small questions on that also. And we'll try to understand the basics of Six Sigma, which is a very new technique. And we'll try to prepare a short note on Six Sigma, small topic. So the first thing which I would like to discuss is what is the difference between descriptive and inferential testing. Okay, now we need to understand these two terms. Descriptive statistics is basically just to describe the statistics in different ways. For example, we have already studied stats up till class 12th that we have summarized the data in table form or in different graphical forms, histogram and ogives and frequency polygons. So when we just try to summarize the data and present it, that comes under descriptive, which we have already studied up till class 12th. And also, we have studied ki how to calculate the central tendencies of a data, that such as mean, mode and median. Different types of means are there: arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean, weighted mean. So that all comes under descriptive, and how we express the variability present in the data. As we all know, if we take the example of length of synthetic fiber and length of cotton fiber, obviously there will be more variation in the natural fibers data. So we need to understand the variation of the data as well after central tendency. So there are different expressions. We'll try to understand that what is the range, what is standard deviation, what is mean deviation, what is percent mean deviation, and what is coefficient of variation. So we'll try to understand different expressions, numerical expressions for expressing the variation in the data. All this comes under descriptive statistics, and these are basics we have already studied. So we'll just revise it in one lecture or so. Otherwise, the most important part of your syllabus comes under inferential statistics. Now, what is inferential statistics? The meaning of inference in English is to conclude. Whenever we have to make some decision from data given, if we have got some data and we need to make some decision and we need to conclude something from this data, then we go for inferential statistics, which is also a very wide field. But under this, we can define inferential statistics as this: it is used to draw conclusions about a population by examining the sample. We can study sample only, and we have to draw conclusions about the population. Under this, we will study two major topics. That is estimation and estimation of population parameter from sample data, which is given in chapter 7 in the book by Leaf, and hypothesis testing. Hypothesis testing is also a very wide term, so we will study only three techniques under this, that is t-test and analysis of variance and chi-square test of goodness of fit and independence of attributes. T-test is given in chapter 8 and chi-square test is given in chapter 9, and ANOVA or analysis of variance or F-test is given in chapter 12 in the book by Leaf. So we'll do some examples by hand, then only we'll be able to understand. So now we have understood what is the meaning of statistics. It is basically collection, organization, analysis, and interpretation and presentation of data. And we have tried to understand the difference between these two terms, that is descriptive statistics and inferential statistics. And try to remember these two terms, which is the major part of your syllabus, that is estimation, hypothesis testing. As we will do these some numerical examples, it will be more clear. So first, just understand these terms. In estimation, we try to estimate a parameter of population from the sample data. And in hypothesis testing, we try to propose a hypothesis or a theory about the data, and then we try to prove it or disprove it according to given data. So when we'll do examples, then only it will be clear. Let us move. These are the different definitions. We already know what is the meaning of population, what is the meaning of sample. Still, we can revise. Population is complete data, complete enumeration of items. Sample is a subset of population. And sample can be classified as random and or biased. Random sample is also called numerical sample. And one of the key definition is every individual has equal chance of being included in sample. All the individuals of the population have equal chance of being included in the sample. Then it is called a random sample or numerical sample. Otherwise, if it is biased in some way or the other, then it comes under biased sample. Okay. Now, what is the difference between parameter and statistic? These both are numerical measures which we need to express mean, standard deviation, different numerical characteristics. But the difference is that parameter is a term which we always use in when we are talking about population, and statistic is a term which we always use when we are talking about the sample mean or sample standard deviation. Next two terms which we come across, these are also the basic terms: primary source of data and secondary source of data. Primary source of data is when data collector is using the data for analysis. Suppose we are doing some research and we are collecting the data and we are analyzing the data, then we are the primary source of data. But if we are doing some research and we are using the data collected by newspapers or somebody else, then it comes under secondary source of data, where person performing data analysis is not the data collector. We are using data collected by somebody else, then that comes under secondary source of data. Now, in different techniques, we'll be using variables. There are different classifications of variables, but in our subject, I'll be limited to these three terms, which are numerical, which comes under numerical or quantitative data. One term is discrete or discontinuous variable, another is continuous variable, and third is ranking data, which comes under subjective assessment. So we just try to understand these three terms. First is discrete or discontinuous data, only whole numbers or integers. For example, number of faults in 100 meter fabric, number of absentees per day. So that data which is integer, 1, 2, 4, whatever. And continuous data is length of garment, linear density of yarn, our heights or weights, that can take any value from 10.1, 10.11 kg or 10.111 kg. So that is a continuous, that comes under continuous data, which has some units of measurement. And number one is discrete or continuous is somewhat type digital or integer form data. Only whole numbers are there. And subjective assessment is basically, for example, comfort of a fabric or beauty of a contestant. We cannot measure beauty or comfort in terms of numbers, but we can rank it. If we have got five fabrics and we are asked to rank the fabrics according to comfort, and whatever rank I am giving and whatever rank you are giving, that can be different. That is why it comes under subjective assessment, but we can rank. We can say this is the best fabric and this is the worst fabric from comfort point of view. So that is ranking data, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we can give ranks. So that doesn't come under discrete data, and that doesn't come under continuous data, that is ranking data. So we'll do some techniques based on ranking data also. So we need to identify the difference between these three types of data. Okay, thank you for today. We'll continue these two terms we'll study in the next class. What is the meaning of random variation and assignable variation? Thank you.